A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 10th March, Sunday. On the front page you have, show us naya action against terror. India tells new Pakistan. So, Pakistan under Prime Minister Imran Khan has said that we are making a new beginning and we are against terrorism. So here you can see his statement given here too. He says that Pakistan government will not allow our soil to be used for terrorist activities anywhere in the world. This is a new Pakistan, a new time. As a responsible country, we will not allow any militant group to function here. So on this, the Indian Minister of External Affairs spokesperson says that if Pakistan claims to be Naya Pakistan with Nayi Soch, it should show Naya action against terror groups and terror infrastructure on its soil and end cross-border terrorism. The next is, Nirav extradition to start soon. So Enforcement Directorate states so. So there has been a request sent to UK government. You can see extradition proceedings will now begin because Nirav Modi has now been identified in UK. So he is staying in UK. So India's request to the Westminster Court, Magistrate Court on his extradition has been referred to. So it is UK's Home Office which has referred the extradition case now. So we are expecting the extradition proceedings to start soon. Then below you have, no campaigning with defense staff posters, Election Commission. So there have been political banners bearing Wing Commander Abhinandan Vardhman's portrait along with Prime Minister Narendra Modi, which are being used as such for campaigning. So Election Commission has clearly stated that no defense personnel posters can be used on posters for campaigning. Then on page 11 you have, relaxation of rules to aid red flagged Andaman's tourism project. So this is regarding the Aves Island project, which has not received clearance from an expert panel in February 2019 because it failed to satisfy the coastal zone regulations. So now for this project there will be relaxation of rules. So Environment Ministry has amended the laws that now allow a proposed tourism project in Aves Island as such to come up. So, because it did not fulfill the coastal regulation zones, the law itself was changed. So, project was only one of the three high-profile proposed tourism projects that did not get a clearance from an expert committee on coastal clearance. So, the reason for not getting clearance was because project was located 20 meters away from high tide line and the existing rules do not allow that. So, existing rules require such projects to be at least 50 meters away. This is the Aves Island project. You should be able to recollect that in December 2018, we had discussed in detail how the government had issued a coastal regulation zone notification which significantly relaxed the norms for coastal regulation and allowed tourism and development projects located near coasts in mainland India. So in mainland it was allowed, and then later even an island zone protection notification with similar provisions was brought out in next month, that is Jan 2019, for similar relaxations in Andaman and Nicobar Islands. So even after these significant relaxations, Aves Island project still did not fulfill the criteria, the 50 meter criteria, because it was 20 meter from high tide line. So now further relaxation has been given to this Aves Island project. Government says that because Andaman and Nicobar Islands has no industries, tourism is only major thrust area which needs to be promoted. So that's why the coastal norms are being compromised. So here you can see what this project calls for is an island resort. So premium tents and tree houses would be put up here. So that's a 100 crore project which has been considered. So there is this Andaman and Nicobar Islands Integrated Development Corporation Limited. So this will develop an island resort here in Aves Island. Then below you have, need to rethink Official Secrets Act, says Hamid Ansari. So this is former Vice President of India, Mr. Hamid Ansari, who says that the Official Secrets Act is archaic and irrelevant. So we had seen how the government had threatened criminal action against media houses in the Rafael papers which have been brought out in the open. So this this goes against the Right to Information Act. So it has quite often come up in news, Official Secrets Act of 1924. It's a colonial era act. So this is important. Then on page 13 you have, Pakistan's request for air route under review. So Pakistan government is now asking for air route access. So here you can see it is India is reviewing this request of Pakistan to open an air route from Mumbai to Karachi and northwards. So this will help it for its flights towards Europe and North America. So India is considering this request. Pakistan has lifted restrictions for civilian flights on other routes. Its eastern airspace continues to be shut for commercial flights. So it is affecting flights entering from and into India. And now it is demanding that Mumbai to Karachi air route should be opened up. So because its eastern airspace is blocked, it continues to be shut. Indian airlines as well as flights from Far East take longer route and burn additional fuel to reach Europe and beyond. Then below you have Swanky terminal for Kartarpur pilgrims. So we have discussed about this also often. Kartarpur Sahib corridor, which has been proposed when India and Pakistan would provide this new connectivity for the Sikh pilgrims who enter into Pakistan to visit the Kartarpur Sahib or pilgrimage to Kartarpur Sahib, the Gurudwara in Pakistan. So center India has approved a state-of-the-art passenger terminal building spread over 50 acres, estimated to cost around 190 crore rupees for the Kartarpur corridor. So that is the news here. So you should know about this Kartarpur Sahib corridor. So it is the Kartarpur Sahib Gurudwara, which will be better accessible from Dera Baba Nanak in Gurdaspur district in Punjab. So it will be this connectivity which the Kartarpur corridor would provide between these two. This is in Pakistan and this is in Gurdaspur district in Punjab in India. Then on international page you have North Korea may be preparing for a missile or space launch report. So based on satellite image analysis, it is said that North Korea is building a rocket. So this is the news coming for now after recently we saw how the talks between US President Donald Trump and North Korean leader Kim Jong-un collapsed in as such. So this were talks in Hanoi, Vietnam, which collapsed. And this is here down here. Trump's budget includes funds for Space Force. So this has earlier also been in news that how USA is now having a separate armed military section called Space Force. So it's a new branch of the military in USA. So you should know about this. So he's seeking money in the budget for the Space Force as such, new branch in the military. For the first time, this has been sought now. Then on business page, you have Tribunal tells IRDAI to renew TPA license. So this is Securities Appellate Tribunal, the appellate body where SEBI decisions are appealed against. So at SAT, the SAT has quashed the regulator's order rejecting Happy Insurance's application. Says its stance is not justified. So SAT has quashed an order of IRDAI, Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India, and it has directed the insurance regulator to renew the license of an entity that was cancelled by IRDAI in July 2016. So these are regulatory bodies and how their relations work. You can see there is a Supreme Court ruling in 2017 also on deciding appeal filed by Happy Insurance. So this intermingling of various regulatory bodies is an important issue. Sometimes there are calls for a super regulator too. So in that context, this is important. And this is IRDAI moots norms on conflict of interest. So boards of companies have to lay out policy. So a set of guidelines to address this conflict of interest arising from appointment of common directors in the insurance sector is to be looked into by IRDAI. There are these guidelines in place now. So these are a draft which have to be, you know, approved, and finally they would be applicable. Then on Sundays you have this who, what, why, when, where coverage. So who, this is regarding Liverpool football, so you can skip it. This is on Official Secrets Act, which is very important. So this was discussed. It is on front page too. Vice President calling for looking to this Official Secrets Act, which is an RCEC Act. And this is, why is GSP vital to India-US trade ties? So this also, over the week, we have seen generalized system of preferences. These preferences have been revoked from India, which was the largest beneficiary among the developing countries for it in USA. EU also provides us similar preferences, GSP, which is WTO approved. So this is regarding that. And this is regarding North Korea preparing for a rocket launch. And this is important, protecting the Sundarbans wetlands. So you should know about the wetlands and the threats which the Sundarbans wetlands face. So it is a wetland of international importance here under Ramsar Convention. Then on Sundays, you have a science and technology coverage page. So here, important news is Bell 2 chasing cousinly rivalry at the subatomic level. So this is Bell 2, which is a particle accelerator experiment located in Tsukuba, which is in Japan. So it's a unique facility in the world. Here, electrons and positrons. Positrons are anti-electrons. So electrons and anti-electrons collide to produce B mesons. So the study is on the breakdown of symmetry in these subatomic particles. So that is the international collaboration experiment which is going on. 26 countries are involved here. So this is important. And also below you have NPL's device produces high quality single layer graphene. So this is National Physical Laboratory of CSIR in New Delhi. So this laboratory has now produced quality of a single layer graphene, which is of metrology grade quality. So this is a technology which has been mastered, and technology transfer will also take place from this CSIR lab to industry. So you should also know about graphene and this entire study too. Plus, on the last page, and there is no news. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com and get into the current affairs section. So that is it. Thank you.